Okay, let's continue with the reaction of aldehyde and ketone. Okay, for reaction of aldehyde and ketone, so the reaction number one is oxidation. Aldehyde can be oxidized to carboxylic acid by a variety of oxidizing agent. For example, potassium permanganate and potassium dichromate. However, ketone are difficult to oxidize. In oxidation of aldehyde, the hydrogen bonded here to the carbonyl carbon is replaced by OH. Okay, here it uses potassium permanganate in the presence of sulfuric acid. H plus is come from acid. And here we have ethanol when it react with potassium permanganate in the presence of acid, and then we heat, then you will get carboxylic acid, or we call as ethanoic acid. Then reduction of aldehyde and ketone involve a common reducing agent. Number one is lithium aluminium hydride. Number two is sodium borohydride. Number three is hydrogen gas in the presence of metal catalyst such as nickel, platinum or palladium at high temperature. It is the reverse process of oxidation of an alcohol. The reduction of carbonyl compound occurs with the addition of hydrogen across the double bond to produce hydroxyl group. Okay, you have here is a primary alcohol. Okay, when this primary alcohol oxidizes, it will produce aldehyde. When this aldehyde is reduced, it will produce back a primary alcohol. When aldehyde is oxidized, again, it will produce carboxylic acid. When this carboxylic acid is reduced, it will produce back primary alcohol. Reduction of aldehyde here also can be used hydrogen in the presence of nickel as a catalyst. So, this double bond O will change to OH. When here is double bond O change to OH because here it use sodium borohydride as reducing agent. H2O will act as solvent here. Reduction of ketone in the presence of hydrogen and platinum as a catalyst. So double bond O here will change to OH. For propanone or ketone here, when it react with lithium aluminium hydride in the presence of acid, it will produce OH here. So in this case, the secondary alcohol produced from this reaction. Reductive amination of aldehyde and ketone is a two-step method that converts aldehyde and ketone into primary, secondary and tertiary amine. The reaction involves the carbon in the C double bond O being attacked by nucleophile. Therefore, it will give two possible outcomes. Nucleophile will attack of the ammonia on the C double bond O to form amine. Reduction of amine to form amine. Reaction of aldehyde and ketone with ammonia. The C double bond O react with ammonia. And then it will combine to produce this we call as a complex because it consists of negative and positive charge. After that, this structure, then we see here hydrogen here, two electron will give to this bond. Here is bond break and it produce H2O. Here you produce amine, double bond, and H. Formation of primary amine. Okay, here is nucleophilic attack. So here is NH plus O minus. Here is H and here is NH2. React with H2O. Then this is eliminate the H2O. Then you will produce amine. When this amine is reduced, it will produce by primary amine. Reduction of aldehyde and ketone with hydroxyl amine. Here you should get here negative, here is positive, and then you remove the H2O here, and then here two electron goes here, then you will get double bond here and oxime. And then for this one, here should be negative, here should be positive, NH2. And then remove the H2O, here two electron here, give to this bond, then you get here double bond. And then the final product we name as hydrazone. When this compound react with C double bond O, here should be negative, positive, this one. And then you eliminate the H2O, two electron from here give or move to this bond, then you will get double bond. Reaction of aldehyde and ketone with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine, 2,4-DNP. A solution of 2,4-DNP in methanol and sulfuric acid is called Brady's reagent. Aldehyde and ketone react with 2,4-DNP at room temperature to give a yellow-orange precipitate of 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. Here, when you see here, here is aldehyde react with 2,4-DNP, so you will eliminate water. After that, double bond will combine with this nitrogen. Get this bond. And then here plus H2O that you eliminate from the first reaction. The name is methanol because here is come from methanol. Methanol 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. When a ketone here and then you remove the H2O, here double bond will combine with this nitrogen to produce this product plus H2O. Then the answer is 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. For nucleophilic addition reaction of C double bond O, nucleophile always remember the mechanism, nucleophile always attack electrophile. So that's why the arrow is come from nucleophile to electrophile. After that, this hydrogen here will be substituted with NU. OH will combine with hydrogen. Aldehyde react with hydrogen cyanide HCN in cool alkaline solution to produce 2-hydroxynitrile, or it is known as cyanohydrine. The importance of addition of hydrogen cyanide is step 1 to lengthen the carbon chain of the molecule by adding one carbon atom to the chain. Number 2 is to produce a group of organic compounds called 2-hydroxycarboxylic acid. Step number 1 involves the nucleophilic attack. So, nucleophilic attack, why this compound is called as nucleophile? Because it contains negative charge. So, it will attack the carbon here. And then at the same time, 2 electrons will give to here. So you get here is negative because this oxygen accept 2 electrons. And at the same time, bond is formed here. After that, this oxygen will extract the hydrogen here. So OH will produce here. Then bond break here. 2 electron goes here. So you will get Cn minus. This is the final product. Actually, it's not really a final product. It is a final product. Okay, example, ethanol. So, what you need to do is you just replace this double bond with single bond and then you add hydrogen here. After that, bond here, you just add single bond and then you just add CN. The name should be 2-hydroxypropanenitrile. 2-hydroxypropanenitrile can be hydrolyzed to give 2-hydroxypropanoic acid. It can be hydrolyzed with water in the presence of acid at high temperature reflux. So here you will produce C double bond OOH. And then CN is converted to carboxylic acid. The reaction is similar with ketone. And then for triiodomethane or iodoform test, this is a test for carbonyl and hydroxyl group that contain the structure of CH3C double bond O, or we call it secondary alcohol. In a simple way, this C double bond O, this carbon, okay, this carbon, the carbonyl carbon should attach at least to one methyl group. So, if let's say this carbon attached to ethyl or propyl or hexyl, so the solution, when we observe the observation, the solution remain unchanged, means that no reaction occurred. So in order to make this reaction happen, you must make sure that carbonyl carbon attach to methyl group. In the reaction, the hydrogen attached to the carbon next to the carbonyl carbon and substituted by halogen. For carbonyl group, only ethanol gives a positive iodoform test, while aldehyde gives negative test. Methyl ketones give a positive iodoform test, so it will form yellow precipitate. Iodine in basic solution react with ethanol to form a yellow precipitate, or we call as triiodomethane. ACHI3. This we call as yellow precipitate, but not really yellow, just light, we call as light yellow. Okay, basically this is the mechanism involved the iodoform test. Okay, here you have this carbonyl carbon attached to CH3 group. When it react with hydroxyl ion in the presence of iodine, so this bond will break, and then this hydrogen will form H2O, and then here it will replace with iodine, I. So that's where you put 3 here, because 1, 2, 3. Then the triiodoternal react with the base to form a yellow precipitate of triiodomethane, or we call as iodoform. So here, this carbon will attach to OH, and then same time these 2 electron will give to here, so that's why you get here negative, because this oxygen accept 2 electron from one of the bond. Okay, after that this bond will break, so you will produce Cl3-, and at the same time this 2 electron will give to this bond to form double bond. So for the laboratory test to distinguish between aldehyde and ketone, we have a few tests to distinguish between aldehyde and ketones. Both aldehyde and ketone contain the carbonyl group. However, the presence of the hydrogen on the carbonyl group gives aldehyde the reducing properties. Because when we see the structure of aldehyde is C double bond OR and H. I repeat again, the structure of aldehyde is C double bond OR H. And the structure for ketone is C double bond O attached to R, and another one R is R prime, another alkyl group. So, because the existence of the hydrogen in the aldehyde structure, so it gives the reducing properties. Therefore, aldehyde are easily oxidized by strong oxidizing agent. Okay, first we can do is toluene test. Basically, toluene is the colorless reagent, no color at all. If you see the toluene reagent, the color is clear. When the toluene reagent is added to an aldehyde, it will form, we call as a complex silver ion, or it form the gray precipitation. So silver ion is reduced to silver metal to form gray precipitation. So when you put aldehyde with the toluene reagent and then you shake the test tube, after you shake for few times, few seconds, and then you will see the gray precipitate form at the bottom of the test tube. The appearance of the silver mirror on the inner wall of the test tube is a positive test for the aldehyde. Why we call a silver mirror? Because the characteristic just like a mirror. Then the color is silver one. And then for the Fehling's and Benedict test, so Fehling and Benedict solution contain copper 2 plus ion in an alkaline medium. So on warming, aldehyde reduce the blue color of Fehling or Benedict solution to brick red precipitate. Basically, the initial color of the Fehling or Benedict solution is blue. When you add this Fehling or Benedict solution with aldehyde and then you put in a warm water bath, after few times, after for about few minutes, then you will observe the formation of brick red precipitate in the test tube. The color change. So for this test, you should put the color change from what to what. If the color, if there is no color changes, so you just put the color remain unchanged. Okay, when you observe the color changing, you must state like this. The color of solution change from blue to red red precipitate solution. Ketone do not react with toluenes and Fehling or Benedict reagent because they do not have the hydrogen atom, because this carbonyl group attached to alkyl and alkyl only. Alkyl is basically here is C and C. Thank you for today.